alarm clock? Do you see the concept behind this?
Yeah, well, I mean, I saw it back when Piper was working on it, okay. So yeah, I know exactly what it is.
Okay, what's your thoughts on it?
I thought it was cool.
Yeah, yeah?
It seems like something that would be very valuable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you got any more kind of options to kind of make like more kind of utility on with Ethereum?
Like second layer utility markets? Yeah, there's a bunch. Especially kind of a bit further in the future, like there's data storage, there's service provision for light clients. So you can make like a computation market for even just like give me the full list of receipts, you know, that have some particular topic key.
Okay.
And then you can just do that, like that whole computation crypto economically, and then make it like way simpler for light clients.
Awesome.
Actually, you can make crypto economic light clients in general, right? Just like have a key that's a huge pile of ether that's in a smart contract where you then sign messages that attest to the block hash, and then people can and then like those if any of those messages are incorrect, then that ether deposit gets penalized.
Oh wow.
Yeah,
okay.
Like there's like that might actually like that would be way lighter than existing light clients, so
yeah.
It might be like really worth implementing at some point. There's on-chain arbitrage bots and bots for participating in like maker type systems, bots for participating in prediction markets. Bots for doing like a whole bunch of third-party services inside of state channels.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, if I have coins inside a state channel and I don't want to kind of come online very often myself, then I could like basically authorize some third party to deposit stuff and like watch the channel and do challenges and meet on my behalf.
Okay.
And you can have off-chain markets for that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Has scheduling been asked for before from the Ethereum community?
I know there was a lot of interest in it way back when Piper created his alarm clock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Very cool. Really appreciate that.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Dad. People are it's basically doing like taking Piper's Ethereum alarm clock.
Yes, I spoke to someone on your team yesterday, I think.
Awesome.
Yeah, and he just described how they want to consider expanding into other like on-chain second layer markets.
Yeah.
Yes, that was my suggestion.
Oh, is it? Okay. Well, that's how the team passed that on to me, so I really appreciate you doing that.
Yeah, so I think it's like a commodifiable service, and like lots of people need it. And you should like develop a long list and a clear standard, and it's something that like at least in initial range, like you could easily write a client add-on that miners would use.
Yeah.
Or you could create a generalized channel network once we get our channels up and running.
Okay. Okay.
Because it's slightly more efficient to do some of this paying in channels.
Right.
Then you take some of the reward stuff off the chain, and it reduces overhead.
Okay. Perfect. So when we get to a longer stage, we'll just communicate with you and show what you're up to.
I'm at L4. Our project is Counterfactual. If you send us an email at hello@counterfactual.com.
Hello.
We always want to talk to anyone who's interested in channelizing their application.
Okay.
Always.
Perfect. I love that. Thank you so much. Amazing conference. Well, thank you so much again.